Question 11, we have this figure with a lot going on, and there's all these things to find. So let's start going through them. So angle F to H to M. So F, H, M. So this angle, what is that angle? And we're going to use our properties that we've learned like in quarter two. This is a vertical angle. If you have two lines that cross, the ones across from each other are the same. So that is 40. I'm actually going to make that bigger so I can write all over it. Okay, so this is 40 because that's 40 and they're across from each other, right? So this is 40. Okay, HL to K. So H. L to K. So we're trying to find this angle. And what do we know about two angles on a straight line? These two angles add to 180. They are supplementary. I almost said complementary. I'm like, that's not right. So to find that, we would take 180 minus 85, which is 95. So this angle is 95. And HKL, so now we're finding the third angle in a triangle. So we're just going to take 180 minus 95 minus 40, the other two angles because they add to 180. So this is 45. And now it's going to jump to a side length. So LK. So what is this side length? I'm gonna skip that. Sorry. And go find my other angles. I like that they're all angles, but that one. So we'll be back to LK. Hold on. Let's go to HMG. So H to M to G. How can we find this angle? Well, we know that that's 40 straight across. And then are any of these triangles similar? HL is 42.5. If they're similar, they're going to have the same angle, remember? So I'm going to compare some sides here. I'm going to look at these two. So if I go 60 to 90. And oh, now I see why I needed HL. Or not HL, I was reading down there. LK. But there's another side. There's this side. Right? If they're similar, they're all going to have the same ratio. So 42.5 over 63.75. So let's see if those are the same. 60 to 90 is going to be two-thirds. Then 42.5 divided by 63.75. They're the same. So these opposite triangles are similar. That means they're going to have the same angles. So that means this is going to be 95 and this is going to be 45. And I bet it goes the other way as well, because if this is 95, this is 85. See down here? They're all lining up. So HMG, that is 85. And then HJL. So now we need this. So this would be our 58 right here. Okay, now I'm going to go back and find L to K. So L to K, I'm going to call it X instead of LK. And I'm going to use these two similar triangles. So X goes with 58.35. And that same ratio is going to be equal to, let's do 60 to 90, because we know that that reduces to two-thirds. All right. So now we have smaller numbers to work with. I'm going to cross multiply. So I have 3 times x equals 2 times 58.35. So 2 times 58.35 is 116.7. And then how do we solve for x? We divide that by 3. So I'm going to take that and divide it by 3 to get 38.9. And that is my side length. That's x. So now we just have to type everything in. 40. Moving it over so I can see 40, 95, 45, 38.9, and then down to those angles that we went back to, 58. And they're all good.